My name is Ioannis Goutos. I'm a consultant plastic surgeon, and both my NHS and private practice is based in London. My areas of expertise include burn care, scar management, as well as body contouring. If you would like to arrange a consultation, please feel free to get in touch. The most popular classification for burn is the one that relates to the degree of damage to the dermis, which is the second layer of the skin. A superficial partial thickness burn is typically blistered, weepy, and painful, and most of those burns tend to heal within 2 weeks with dressings. A deep partial thickness burn has a drier appearance, is less weepy and less painful, given that more blood vessels and nerves have been destroyed during the burn injury. A proportion of deep partial thickness burns will need an operation in order to ensure prompt healing. Full thickness burns are the most severe degrees that we find in clinical practice, where the entirety of the skin has been burned. They tend to have a dry, waxy, leathery appearance, and the overwhelming majority of them need to be treated with an operation, apart from the very small ones. The administration of appropriate first aid following a burn is of paramount importance in order to prevent further damage within the wound and improve its healing potential. Most specialists would recommend the following steps. A. Stop the burning process. B. Remove any loose clothing and jewellery from the affected area. C. Cool the burn down by using running water for 20 minutes whilst maintaining the rest of the body warm. D. Cover the wound with cling film or a clean cloth. And E, seek appropriate medical attention. The healing time for burn injuries depends on a number of factors, including the extent, the depth, the location, as well as the underlying mechanism of injury. If we look at superficial partial thickness burns, these tend to heal within 2 weeks, and most of them in an uneventful manner. If we look at deep partial thickness and full thickness burns, they will take longer than 2 weeks to heal, and very frequently we intervene with a skin graft procedure in order to ensure optimal healing. What we know from the latest research is that when it comes to burns healing, every day counts. In other words, the quicker the burn heals, the lower the risk for unfavorable scarring. This makes prompt assessment and management by a specialist burns consultant imperative in order to achieve the best possible outcome. Burns can be very traumatic experiences, leaving behind significant scarring. Surgery may be indicated in order to optimize wound healing and contribute to a better scar quality. Burn repair surgery can be divided into acute, which is performed immediately after the burn injury, or reconstructive, which aims to resurface existing scars. There are a variety of options that are available when it comes to burn surgery. When we look at acute burn surgery, one of the commonest operations is a skin graft. This involves the transfer of healthy layers of the skin onto the clean burn wound in order to speed up healing. Occasionally, we use flaps. These are units of tissue that are transferred from one place to the other in order to cover defects. We're also privileged to be able to use what we call dermal templates in burn surgery. These are collagen-based sheets of animal origin that can be placed onto the wound before a skin graft achieves wound healing. There is also emerging technology involving spray skin cells that are aimed to regenerate the epidermis, which is the top layer of the skin.